Most of the students have joined now. So good morning again, everyone. 12th class, and we were doing planning, and only last one topic was left. So we were doing that, and before going to that topic, I'm just giving a brief intro of all the topics, whatever we have done. Meaning of planning in this chapter we have done. Then features of planning. Planning focus on achieving objectives, or planning is a goal-oriented process. Then planning is a primary function of management. Planning is pervasive. Planning is continuous. Planning is futuristic. Planning is a mental exercise. It means it requires a lot of mental attributes to do plan. The person who is not having logical reasoning, analyzing power, thinking power, he cannot make good plans. So that's why it is said that it's a mental exercise. Next topic was whatever we have done. I'm not explaining the topics in detail, as already we have done these topics. So I'm just giving only the headings for a quick recap. Then importance or advantages of planning. Planning provides direction. It tells us what to do and how to do. And by following that directions, we can achieve our objective. Planning reduces the risk of uncertainty, as we all know that the future is uncertain. And by making plans, we can reduce this uncertainty. Planning reduces overlapping and wasteful activities. When everything will be decided in advance and we will be just following it, then there will be no confusion and no misunderstanding. And definitely it will reduce the overlapping and wasteful activities. Then next is planning is promotes innovative ideas. As you all know that it is the very important feature of the planning that it requires mental attributes. So whenever we are making plans, then sometimes suggestions are asked from the employees or all those who have to actually implement those plans. So it promotes innovative ideas. When all the people in the organization will be giving their suggestions, some suggestions may be best suggestions. We can opt them. Then planning facilitates decision making. It helps us what to do, and it helps in taking the decisions in regard to the future. Then the next is planning establishes standards for controlling. If we want to control anything, then we must need standard. And you have already done the process of planning. It means the standards are set in the first step of the process of planning. No planning, no control. We can say control is blind without planning. Then planning improves efficiency. It's very much correct that the planning improves efficiency. Why planning improves efficiency? As it removes the wastage of efforts. So it requires efficiency. Limitations of planning. Planning leads to rigidity. As every picture has two aspects, so we have done this limitations. Some external limitations are there, some internal limitations are there. External limitations are just about the environmental problems. So we are not considering here those environmental problems. Basically, we are like natural calamity and other things. But here we are considering the internal limitations of the planning only. Planning leads to rigidity. हमने ये कर लिया था. Because whatever is said, every employee has to follow that only. So planning may not work in dynamic environment. Business environment keeps on changing. It's not static. It's dynamic. So it may not work in dynamic environment. Then planning reduces creativity. As whatever is said, every employee has to follow that only. So there is no scope for using their own innovative ideas. At the time of making of plans, the ideas are invited. So at the time of formulation of plans, it leads to the ideas. But once the plan is formulated, then everyone is to follow that plan only. So that's why in this manner it reduces creativity. Because whatever is prepared by the top management or the bosses, the employees have to just follow it. They are not allowed to deviate from the plan. Then planning involves huge cost. I told you that planning is a very lengthy process, and it involves the holding of the different meetings, collection of the data, facts, analyzing, finding out the pros and cons of every alternative. Then it will be taking a lots of funds. So it's a time consuming process also, as you have seen that it's a lengthy process. So in each step it will take time, and in this limitation I told you that there must be time left to implement the plan. We should not take so much of time in the formulation of plans that no time is left for its implementation. So we should keep this thing in mind. Limitations may make step planning does not guarantee success. Yes, we have already studied it, that plans are to be implemented in the future and future is uncertain. So planning does not guarantee success. Means once, suppose one plan we have tested in the previous year and that has given us good results. It does not mean that the same plan will be giving us good results or better results in the same year also. Why? Because in this year, the situations, the environment may be different from the next year. So the one successful plan is not the guarantee of the success of every time. So in every time, we have to change the plans according to the situations. Then process of planning. In process of planning, these steps, seven steps we have done. First step, setting objectives. In this step, objectives are set up. I told you here that objectives must be SMART. Then second is developing premises, future assumptions, I told you. We have to take assumptions to make the plans. And our plans will be based on those assumptions. Assumptions are made about the change in the business environment, government policy, tax rate, consumer taste and preferences, and other things. Next is the identifying the different alternatives. I told you that planning is required where there are options. If there are no option, then there is no need of planning. So wherever there are options, then we have to select the best one. And to select the best one, we have to make the plan. So which will be best for us. So in this method, whatever the objective we have set up to achieve that objective, we have to find out the various alternatives. For doing one task, there may be different manners, different ways, different options to complete that task. So in this step, we have to list down all the various alternatives for achieving the objectives. Next, planning, evaluating. After finding out the different alternatives, we have to evaluate each and every alternative. Evaluating means listing down the positive points and the negative points of each and every alternatives. We have to find out that what are the positive points, which option is feasible, which is not feasible. We have to analyze each and every option on the basis of cost and profit analysis. Means what will be the cost involved in one option and what will be the profits available in that particular option. So the option in which cost is more and the profits are less will be denied at this step only. Then the next, we will be giving the ranks to the options like this: below average, satisfactory, very good, excellent, outstanding. And last one is the fifth, second last, selecting an alternative. Means after making the list of all the alternatives, after analyzing it, then we have to select the best one. Best one means, suppose we have ranked all these options, five options were there, and we have ranked the five options in this manner. So the outstanding option will be selected, the best option. Best option means the option in which the costs are minimum and the profits are maximum, so that the profits can be increased. Then the implementation, now the plan must be communicated. So till here, we were just making the plans. Yahan par aapka plan ban gaya hai. Now we have to implement it. So for implementing means putting the plan into action. Means whatever we have thought, now we have to execute it. Time to execute it. So it means do what is required. Okay, so in this step, plan will be communicated to the lower level employees who have to actually implement the plan. Then follow up means checking the plan, whether whatever the assumptions we had taken are holding true or not. So this is about the follow up. If the plan is not getting successful, situations are adversely changed in the future, then we have to make changes in our plan accordingly. Otherwise, the total amount and the time, whatever we have invested in making of plans, will be wasted. Next, planning process. This is the flow chart, and I told you here one thing. So whenever you are explaining any process, then you need to explain with the help of flow chart. So this type of flow chart is very much required while explaining the process. Okay, next, last topic of the chapter is types of plan, which is new topic for today. Types of plans. So basically, plans are of two types: standing plans and single use plans. As the name specify that the single use plans are programs and budget. Single use plan means the plans which will be used single time means like use and throw. See, once you have made the plan, then After using that plan, the same plan could not be used for the next year. So this type of plans are known as single use plans, means the plans which are for a short term, which are for short term. Short term means which cannot be used for a long term. We have prepared those plans only for one use. So on the basis of the use and the length, their use and length, plans are divided in, classified in two parts, single use and standing. And standing plans, as the name implies, that the plans which will be keep on standing. Keep on standing means the plan used for activities that occur regularly over a period of time. Means the same plan we will be using for a regular period of time. Clear? Here, objective and strategies are written in standing plan, but in this PPT, this will not should be here. So you will say that standing examples of standing plan are policy, procedure, methods, and rules. The examples of standing plan are only four: policy, procedures, methods, and rule. And single use plan, programs, and budget. And one by one, now we will be explaining all types. And objective and strategy are the types of plans which are neither standing nor single use. Okay, so it is a very important one marker question. Then which are the plans which are neither standing plans nor the single use plans? So the answer is objective and strategy are neither standing plans nor single use plans. Okay, am I clear? Standing plans means the plans which we have made one time and that will be used again and again for future course of action. Like policy, whatever the policy the organization has made, that will be used again and again same year. Like no credit sales is the policy of the organization. So this policy will be not keep on changing after every month. We can use the same policy year after year. So now in detail, we will be studying all these plans and a difference chart in between standing plan and single use plan is very much important. Why? Because 3 to 4 marker question in board can come in the difference in between single use plans and standing plans. I'm telling you here some differences. Pehle hum kar lenge types of plan, only then you will be able to understand the difference in between the standing plans and single use plans. So one by one we will be doing, and make sure that objectives and strategies are neither standing plans nor single use plans. Okay, so first, this I have already explained. Standing plan is used for activities that occur regularly over a period of time. It is usually developed once but is modified from time to time to meet business needs as required. Standing plans includes only four, here it is mentioned: policies, procedures, methods, and rules. Four. Total 8 subtopics are there in this topic. Single use plan is developed for a one time event or project. Means we are making the plan for one project. As soon as the project is over, the plan is also over. The same plan cannot be used for the next project. Such a course of action is not likely to be repeated in future. They are for non-recurring situations, and standing plans are for recurring. Recurring means which occurs again and again, and non-recurring means which do not occur again and again. The duration of this plan may depend upon the type of project. It may be for 1 year, for 2 year, for 5 year. It may extend for a week or for a month. Okay. Single use plan means ki only once it will be used. So for a day, for only 1 week, for only 1 month, or for the completion of the project only. Then also it will be used, known as single use plan. Suppose you have made a plan for completing a project, and then project will be ended after 3 years. So the single use plan will be, it will be known as single use plan. A project may sometime be of only one day, such as organizing an event or a seminar or conference. So it depends on project, on the length of the project. So first is the objectives. Objectives, I think I have already explained while explaining the steps in the planning process. I told you about objectives. Objectives are the goals, are the ends towards which every activity is aimed. Whatever we are doing, we have an aim behind that doing. So that aim is our objective, our goal. Sometimes goals and objectives are synonyms. It is misunderstood that goals means general objectives and objectives means specific. Like we are saying that we want to increase the profits. So it can be the goal, not the objective. So for becoming it objective, it must be specific. Specific means like we want to increase the profits by 30% this year, then it will become the objective. So objectives are always specific. And I told you one more thing about objectives. In the process, I'm going back. In the process of planning, at this first step, I told you that goal setting, specific. So this you can use there. If goal or objective has come in exam, then you can use this word here, acronym here, that is the SMART. SMART means objectives must be specific. Like I told you, 10% profit. So it is the specific. Measurable means which can be measured in terms of quantitative. Then achievable. Achievable means within our capabilities. Then realistic. Real hona chahiye. Imaginary nahi hona chahiye. Then timely. It means it must be time bound. So wherever you are going to explain objectives, you can use the word SMART. Objectives must be SMART. Okay. SMART means S for specific, M for measurable, A for achievable, R for realistic, T for time bound. Okay. Any examples you can take, like production department may have the objective like defective units. We will try to reduce the defective units by 10%. Increase the production by 20%. Sales department objective can be increase the sales by 30%. One more objective can be there because a lot of money is spent on selling expenditure. So sales department can set the objective of reducing the selling expenditures, like 10% expenditure on sales will be reduced. Means advertisements vagera pe jo hum expense kar rahe the, usko hum kam kar denge. Next. Second is strategy. It's a very important plan actually. बहुत बार board में इस पर बेटा 3 marker question भी आया है. आप लोगों ने सुना भी होगा game field में strategy बहुत use होती है. Like अभी जो China India का चल रहा है उसमें भी strategy, China is making its strategy and India is making its strategy. So strategy is used wherever the competition is there. तो जब भी कभी आपको बेटा ये जो आप types कर रहे हैं ना, ये direct नहीं आते हैं question में कभी भी. There will be always a case study. We will do the practice of those case studies, and in that case study you have to identify the type of plan, means whether on the basis of the case given in the question, whether it is objective, whether it is policy, whether it is procedure, and the case study will be very confusing. So you have to understand all these 8 type of plan in a very descriptive manner, so that each and every line of the case study is clear. Because if you are thinking in one manner, then you will see that the answer is strategy. Then again you are going to read the question, then you will find the answer is not strategy, answer is policy. So you may confused. So the clarity of the concept is very much important, and many times a 6 marker question has come on the types of plans. So it's a very important, and normally 100% in exam, the question comes on this topic, whether it is a 1 marker, 3 marker. So strategy, while studying the case study, you have to keep in mind one thing, that if the, in case study, competition is talked about, competition, then answer may be strategy, because strategy, every organization is preparing its own strategies to win over the competition. So competitor has made its own strategy, and to face that competition, we have to also prepare our strategy. Like in game field, 2 opponent teams are playing match. So if one team has changed its strategy, then other team is also forced to change its strategy to keep in mind the competitor's strategy. Getting my point? So every time, whenever the competition is talked about in case study, then we may find the answer is strategy. So strategy is the, we can define it strategy. So strategy is a comprehensive plan. So I'm giving you some lines, which may prove the case study breaker lines. So wherever the comprehensive plan word is written, comprehensive plan means complete plan, which includes various steps for accomplishing organization objectives. A business objective without a strategy is just a dream. It's a very good line. Business objective without a strategy means until or unless the organization is making its own strategy, it cannot achieve the organizational goal. Like for example, objective is to increase company's profit by 10%. This is the objective set in the first step in the planning process. To achieve this objective, company can adopt strategies like, now the company has to think about how this objective can be achieved. So to achieve this objective, what strategies can be there? Like they can launch new products, and by the sale of new products, they can increase their profits. Then introduce new distribution channels. Like earlier, they were using only in marketing. You have studied about the distribution channel. Like earlier, they were using only indirect channels. Now they have started using the direct channel also, or the zero level channel. Now they have created their websites. Like earlier, the businesses which were using the indirect channels, now each and every business is going to use the websites or the other direct channels, because due to the present COVID situation, no one wants to go outside. So that's why they have changed their strategy. Like online sales, select new advertisements media like internet marketing, etc. Earlier you were giving ad in newspapers. Now due to COVID situation, people don't want to read newspaper. So now you may give your advertisements on the internet, on the Facebook or the Facebook, sorry, and on other different social media accounts where people are surfing these days. So one more thing which is not given in this slide, please note down, that is a very important point under strategy. Strategy has three dimensions. You can write down, students. Strategy has three dimensions. Which three dimensions? First, determining long-term objectives. Please write down, because many times this question has been asked in one marker question. Strategy has three dimensions. What is the definition of strategy? It's a complete comprehensive plan. Complete comprehensive plan to achieve the organizational goal. Okay. And keeping in mind the competitors, it is always prepared. Then strategy has three dimensions. First, determines the long-term objectives of the organization. Second, adopting a particular course of action. So in first step of strategy, we will decide the long-term objectives. Means in future, whatever will be the objectives in long term, it will be decided. And second step, adopting a particular course of action. What does it mean? It means we will be adopting a particular course of action. Particular course of action means what action will be taken to achieve the organizational goal. What action will be taken to achieve the organizational goal? Then third step, write down, allocating the resources. Write down, please, everyone. Allocating the resources. Allocating the resources necessary to achieve organizational goal. Allocating the resources necessary to achieve organizational goal. So first step is determining the long-term objectives for the organization, and second is adopting a particular course of action. Adopting a particular course of action. Particular course of action means how we can achieve our objective. Third is allocating resources necessary to achieve the objectives, means doing the arrangements of the resources to achieve the given objectives. Okay, so am I clear with the strategies? Long-term comprehensive plan prepared to achieve the organizational objectives, keeping in mind the competition. Okay. For example, the marketing strategy of a company may include who are the consumers, means for whom we are going to make the product, what is the demand for the product, what is the pricing policy, which channel of distribution we want to use, how do we advertise the product. Like we can say the Pepsi and Coca-Cola are the two competitors, and there is a cutthroat competition in between the Pepsi and Coca-Cola. So if the Coca-Cola has reduced the price, both are perfect substitute to each other. So if the Coca-Cola has reduced the price, so keeping in mind their strategy, the Pepsi brand has to also reduce its price. Otherwise, the survival of Pepsi will become difficult, because many of the consumers will substitute their demand from Pepsi to Coke if they are not reducing the price. So this is the example of strategy. And the next is the two we have done out of eight. Third is the policy. So policy, the main important case study line, breaker line, is the general guidelines. I'm giving you lines in case study. You will be finding out those lines itself. Otherwise, aapko sab ek jaisa hi lagega. Sirf in lines ki help se hi aap case study break kar paoge. So policy mein aapko likha milega comprehensive plan. and sorry, in strategy it will be written comprehensive plan, and in policy it will be written general guidelines. I'm giving you some more words, write down: general guidelines, broad parameters. General guidelines, broad parameters. Okay, so now definition: policies are general guidelines which brings uniformity in decision making. Which brings uniformity in decision making for achieving of predetermined objectives. You have to keep in mind one thing, that whatever the type of plan we are doing, that will be definitely helping us to achieve the objectives, because whatever the plans we have made, that is just to achieve the objectives. So policies are the general guidelines or broad parameters. Why I'm telling you broad parameters? Because these parameters are decided, and all the managerial decisions means whatever the decisions manager has to take, they have to take within these parameters. They cannot go beyond these parameters. So there are different examples of the policies. For example, no credit sale, only cash sale. This is the very good example. Like in a school, what can be policy? We don't give admission in science to the students who have got below 85% marks. So this is their policy, that the only those students will be getting admission in science stream who will be getting 85% marks in 10th class. So different type of policies, like no refund. It is a policy, whatever they have sold, that will be not taken back and the money will not be refunded. No exchange on Saturdays and Sundays. Like you have purchased some goods from a shop and you want to exchange it, but just because of rush on the Saturdays and Sundays, so they have made it their policy that there will be no exchange on Saturdays and Sundays. Many other examples can be there. Policy of the company is that we deal only with the wholesalers. Means in retail sale, we are not doing. We deal only with the wholesalers. Some more examples, like MACD policy is not to give franchising to an individual who already owns another fast food restaurant. So this can be the policy of the MACD, that the MACD cannot be, MACD is not giving franchisee to any other person who is already having some other food chain. Okay, so this can be the policy. Like one more be the policy, like in every organization, whenever there any higher level post is vacant, like one general manager is retired, so that post could be filled only by the promotions, means outsiders will not be given the higher level post. So there can be different examples of the policy. So this is the policy. No credit, please don't ask. Sale policy, payment policy, different type of policies are there. Next, procedure. Procedure means sequence of steps, series of steps. And procedure means always we are following the steps in sequence. Like I told you, planning process. So planning process is a good example of procedure. In that process, I told you 7 steps, and all the steps are arranged in a sequence. And we have to follow that sequence to complete the planning process. We cannot skip one step to reach the other step, or we cannot do the 7th step at the second step. Getting my point? So procedure means series of steps taken together to achieve again objectives. So whatever plans we have done to achieve the objectives, they are always arranged in a chronological order. Arranged in a chronological order. So it's a way of doing the job, like admission procedure in a school. So there are different steps to get admission in a school. There may be written test, submission of application, written test, oral test, then you will be admitted. Then your documents will be authenticated. Like selection procedure in an organization, if you want to get a job somewhere, then you have to follow the procedure. Like you may appear for the interview, then written test, then demo. There may be different steps for the procedure. Even leave it all these examples, very simple example, if you are cooking any food, then it is a procedure. It is having a procedure, and you have to follow that procedure in sequence. You cannot skip any step. So procedure is a series of steps taken together. You have to take all the steps one by one to achieve a desired result. Okay, so procedure is necessary to speed up the performance. So one thing more here is procedures are rigid. Rigid means you cannot change procedure by your own. So whatever the procedures are there, you have to follow them strictly. Okay. Next, methods. So method is a manners of doing the work, ways of doing the work or manners of doing the work. Okay. Ways of doing the work or manners of doing the work means how we can do the task. Like in a planning procedure, the fourth step I told you, listing down the various alternatives. Alternatives are the methods, means there can be different methods to complete the given task. We have to select the best one. And these methods are standardized ways of doing the task. Like in accounts, there are two methods of calculating depreciation, straight line method and written down value method. So written down value method has its own manner for performing the question, and straight line method has its own manner. So we can say method means manners or the ways of doing the routine task. And method can be a step in the procedure. Like in planning procedure, finding out the different methods, different options are the one example. Like nowadays there are different methods for making the payment. Like if you want to pay even school fees also, there are different options. NEFT kara sakte hain, bank mein check se kar sakte hain, online payment. There are different options. Like agar aap apna food home delivery kara rahe hain, food ki bhi online aap khareed rahe hain. So there are different options to make the payment for options. Methods means options. Next, rules. So rule is very important, and you may be confused in policy and rules. Policy are the general guidelines, and the line for the rules is rules are the specific statements of what should be done or what not should be done. As a student, you must be familiar with the rules. Like latecomers will not be allowed. It is a rule for the school. In examination hall, the latecomers will not be allowed. Use of cell phone is strictly prohibited. No smoking in public places. So rules are always associated with fines and penalties. In policy, sometimes you may feel that policy is also a rule. But the minor difference in between rules and policy is that both are the statements. One is the general and the other one is the specific. Second thing, rules are rigid. Rigid means whatever is a rule made, each and every person has to follow the same rule. No deviations are allowed. But policy is little bit flexible. We can change. Like our policy is no credit sales, but if one known to person has come, then we may offer him credit. So we can change the policy. So little bit flexibility is there in policy, but in rules there is no flexibilities. Rules are always made to create discipline in the organization. Okay. So no smoking, no admission, without no littering, without permission, using mobile phones during office hours is permitted. And wherever there is a rule, there is always a penalty for the rule breakers. So rules are always associated with the penalties, but for policies, there are no penalties. So all the standing plans we have done. And a single-use plan, we will complete in tomorrow's class. And tomorrow also, we will be discussing the questions and the case studies. And today, we have done only the standing plans. I am repeating, taking the name of all. Objectives, strategy. Strategy and objectives are neither standing nor single-use. Then policy we did. Then procedures and methods. And the last one is rules. Okay, students? So tomorrow I will take your doubts for the chapters, and we will discuss the complete chapter, and we will be completing it. Okay. So after 5 minutes, next class will start, students. So now I'm ending here meeting. Goodbye, everyone.